Stop wearing that foundation mask on your face. Let's pick the right shade for you. Let me show you how to go from here to here. Coming up.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Val here.
George here.
With Pretty Blended, bring you the best simple tips and tricks on how you can look and feel better.
If you just came,
consider subscribing. So last week, I went to a shop which sells a famous makeup brand. And since I was looking at a foundation which I haven't used before, I asked the consultant to give me my closest shade. He took a bottle from the shelf and asked me to follow him to the mirrors. Then he applied some of the foundation on this part of my neck. I was shocked from the place he decided to match me, but I said, okay, let's leave him to do his job. And then he probably said, yes, that's it, that's your perfect shade. I thanked him for the match, which was too pink even for my neck. And I went back to the shelf. I asked him to show me the bottle and he was so disappointed that I didn't like the color. He then placed the bottle back on the shelf where I saw the number. Are you joking now? I don't even remember the number of the makeup because the only thing I remembered was the undertone which he showed me. I tried to smile, I had a look at the other numbers, and I found medium olive. I noticed that the number which I wanted was out of stock and I was trying to decide if the guy wanted to sell me the foundation because he doesn't have any idea of makeup or because he doesn't have my shade in stock. Both ways, if I didn't know anything about my skin tone, I would spend a nice amount of money on a foundation which I couldn't fix with anything. Because guys, the foundations have intensity and undertones. You can fix the intensity, but you can't fix the undertone. I'm telling you this story just because it happened to me many times with different brands, expensive makeup, and it's always disappointing for me because I've spent some time to learn for colors and undertones, but not everybody needs to do that. So why we have shop assistants if we knew everything about makeup and skincare? Long story short, here I give you the most important information for picking up your foundation and stop spending your money on. Tip number one, check your skin tone in a daylight. Check your face, check your neck, check your chest, your arms, everywhere, your body in general. Do it in a towel, it's easier. Foundation shade should match the most exposed skin on your body, not on your face. The more knowledge for your own skin, the cheaper for you. Check your veins, here on this part, here on this part. If they look greenish, kind, brownish, greenish, so you've got warm undertone. If they look purplish, pinkish, you are in the cool undertone. And if you've got a mixture of both, you are right there in the middle with neutral undertone. Once you know your undertone, you're good to go shopping. The lights in the shops are the worst lights possible. The colors never look the way they do in a daylight. Tip number two. Don't try foundation on places where you have pimples, pigmentation or redness. Tip number three. Don't look at your face only. Remember, we are looking for uniformity, not a face mask. Tip number four. Try the makeup from about a finger from your ear down to the sides of your neck. Not here, never the front of your neck. Your neck is always lighter than your face. A good place to try is on your chest. Just mind if only a part of your chest is exposed to sun all of the time. Next tip, was it five? Anyway, tip number five. A dog is barking and my neighbors are shouting, but I need to do this video today. So just don't mind that. Never match just a bit of foundation. Always divide your face in two and apply the two closest shades possible. You don't need to buy the foundation immediately. Just take a mirror, go in the daylight and check the overall color of your body and face together. I've noticed that many people feel obligated to buy something once they've tried it, but no, it shouldn't be like this. The shop can't offer you the right lights so you can make your choice and buy the foundation immediately. Stay with me because in the end of this video, I'll give you a bonus tip on how you can fix the intensity of your foundation on a budget. Let's keep going. Tip number 6. If you know for a fact that you have warm undertone, never buy foundation which says N or C for neutral or cool. And the opposite. If you have pink undertone or cool undertone, never try to match yourself with a foundation which is warm. I'm gonna sit and I'm gonna wait for the dog to stop barking. All day. Tip number 8. Anyway, don't rely on numbers and names when you pick foundation. They don't mean anything. Different brands have different shades. Doesn't mean that 220 from L'Oreal will be the same like 220 from Revlon. Always try a bit here on this part of your wrist. Have a look and try to see which ones are the closest to your skin tone and then try them on your face. Next tip. When you have swatches here on your hand, you can easily see when something is pink, when something is neutral, and when something is warm. Birds are singing as well, I'm sure you can hear them. The wrong shade of foundation will give you ashy tone if it's too neutral or pink, sick look if it's too pale, a patchy look if you matched your foundation on places where you have pigmentation or redness. The Oompa Loompa look if it's too yellow or dark. Dirty look if it's too warm with too much olive in it. It doesn't matter which shade you just chose, always blend some of the foundation down to your neck. And here is the bonus tip I promised you early on. If you already own a few foundations with the same undertone, don't be afraid to mix and match. But if you don't, this is what I have for you. This is the foundation mixer from NYX. They have a few different types for changing the texture and the color of foundations. Just get one or two from them depending from the colors of foundations you already have. The white one is to lighten a color, deep one to darken a color, orange one to warm up the color, and olive one to add olive undertone. And last but not least, always balance your neck with some bronzer. Okay guys, that was all from me for today, and if you found value in this video, please don't forget to subscribe. Have a nice day and see you soon.